How many dinosaurs are there? Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Brigger. I'm a paleontologist at Utah State University, teaching in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. We can break this question into two separate questions. First, how many dinosaur species have been discovered and named in the literature? And second, how many dinosaur species are there that have yet to be discovered? We can look at a number of ways to measure the diversity or richness of dinosaurs in the fossil record. We can calculate the number of dinosaur families, genera, or species. The number of species is referred to as species richness. But we can also look at diversity, that is the proportion of each type of dinosaur in an assemblage. Now today we're going to focus on species richness. That is, how many dinosaur species were there during the Mesozoic? Now there's been a number of published papers attempting to answer the total number of dinosaur species. Barrett et al. In 2009 came up with the total number of 662 total non-avian dinosaur species. While Michael Benton in the year before, in 2008, he came up with 675 non-avian species of dinosaurs, noting that there was 1,401 named species, but he only considered 675 of those species as valid dinosaur species. So what makes a valid name? Well, first, the dinosaur is based on good material, such as a fairly complete skeleton with multiple specimens and has been published by multiple authors in multiple papers. So anyone can name a new dinosaur on any old fossilized bone, but valid names are the ones that are supported by good fossil material. Now note that we could increase these species numbers if we took into account what is called ghost lineages, which is where you'd have like two species, for example, that originated from a shared ancestor. And then looking at them, they must have overlapped in time. And this would give you a temporal overlap of two species. When normally, when you're counting through these things, you would count each species as representing one species of each time interval. This is important when you're comparing species richness from different time periods. All right, so we have about, you know, between 662 to 675 dinosaur species, which is not many when you consider that there is 9,956 species of living birds. So in a sense, we are living during a great diversity of dinosaurs, which are all feathered and flying all around us. So this brings us to the second and more difficult question. That is, how many dinosaurs have yet to be discovered? Now, one way we could calculate this is if we assumed that there were as many dinosaurs living during the Mesozoic as there are currently living birds, which would indicate that we still have 9,281 or so dinosaur species yet to be discovered, and we've only found about 7% of the known dinosaurs. But species die out, and they're replaced over time. So if we assume that a species duration is about 5 million years, then we can multiply this number by 27. That is the number of 5 million intervals during the Mesozoic when dinosaurs lived. So if we do that, we get about 250,000 dinosaur species that are unknown. And this means that we've only found 0.2% of the known dinosaurs. Now, if we look at the number of species of dinosaurs through time, we notice something interesting, that most of the diversity, most of the numbers of species of dinosaurs are at the very end of the Mesozoic, during the late Cretaceous, and that over the 235 or so million years that dinosaurs have been around on the Earth, they have increased in diversity or increased in species richness through time. So then using this linear line, then we can have the total estimate, and that'll give us 125,000 species still unknown. Although this assumes that they are as rich as birds at the end of the Mesozoic, at the late Cretaceous. Now there's another way that scientists have attempted to answer this question, and that's to look at the amount of geographical exposure there is of Mesozoic rocks. You could take a geological map of the world, for example, here is Utah, and you can measure the area where the exposed rock layers are Mesozoic strata, and then divide this by the number of dinosaur species found in that area, and calculate a species density, and then apply this to the entire world to see how many more dinosaurs would be discovered from places that are less well explored. All right, let's do this for Utah. Note that some of these numbers I'm going to use are tracks or traces of different dinosaur types, or sometimes fragmentary remains that are only identified to family. I used the number from the Dinosauria, which is the second volume of the Dinosauria big giant book here, where they list the dinosaurs for each state and use those. So there have been some additional dinosaur discoveries here in Utah since 2004, but we're going to just kind of use these numbers to show you how to work out this method. So if we look at it, the Cretaceous, there's 91 dinosaur species or different types of dinosaurs in Utah. In the Jurassic, we have 44 different types of dinosaurs or dinosaur species. And in the Triassic, we have 5 different types of dinosaurs or dinosaur species. Now you'll notice that there are more dinosaurs during the Cretaceous than the Jurassic, and more in the Jurassic than the Triassic. And this could be related to two things. It could be related to the amount of Cretaceous rocks, there's just more Cretaceous rocks here in Utah, or it could be to the fact that there's an increasing diversity or increasing richness of dinosaurs through the Mesozoic, and so there are just more dinosaurs at the end of the Cretaceous, which is the youngest strata. All right, so let's get density numbers by examining the geological maps of each of these layers of rocks. So Cretaceous rocks here in Utah cover 11,211 square miles. In the Jurassic, they cover 10,060 square miles, while in the Triassic, they cover 8,602 square miles of Utah. Now, if we divide these numbers with the numbers of dinosaurs for each period of time, we get different dinosaur density values. So in the Cretaceous, there's a new species of dinosaurs every 123 square miles, while in the Jurassic, there's a new dinosaur species every 229 square miles, and in the Triassic, there's a new dinosaur species every 1,720 square miles. So we can use then these numbers to apply to the entire Earth with 58.444 million square miles of land surface. So if the fossil density of Utah was applied to the whole planet, then we would have 471,322 species of Cretaceous dinosaurs, 255,213 Jurassic dinosaurs, and 33,979 species of Triassic dinosaurs. That is a whole lot of dinosaurs. And we only have 675 valid species today. Another thing we can do is look at the number of how many dinosaur species are discovered each year and to project these numbers into the future. So on average, there's about 30 new species of dinosaurs that are named each year, which means that it would take about 8,333 years to name 250,000 undiscovered dinosaurs. So we have a long way to go in discovering new dinosaurs. Now, one of the interesting trends is that the quality of the fossil material that we're basing these new names of species of dinosaurs on has increased over time. So today, you need more material and better fossils to describe a new species. And you don't really name new species on fragments of a tooth or a bone like they used to do in the olden days. So I guess this video kind of just tells you that we don't really know how many dinosaurs are yet to be discovered. All right, so you should be able to sort of describe these methods I've outlined in estimating the number of dinosaur species that have lived in the past.